Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Policenauts Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Hopefully this episode finishing up my reading of the glossary. People don't want to hear me reading aloud glossary, skip the episode. I'm pretty sure that's all it's going to be, unless I doubt it's going to be short, because we've got two more categories to go and they're all long. So, society. Yep. So, okay, why is 1G meal? I guess because that's on Earth, and 0G meal is under outer space. Alright. Because we just read about 0G meal. Now we're going to read about 1G meal. A type of meal sold at the maximum fast food restaurant chain, its standard offering containing food and beverages designed for consumption under 1G. Maximum sells two types of meals in space, the 1G meal and the 0G meal. The 1G meal is only available for limited periods of time on Beyond Coast, and because its contents are imported, the carbonation beverage normally included with it is replaced with an alternative. Therefore, this version differs from the 1G meal sold on Earth. Adhesive carpet. A type of carpet designed to make the floors of weightless areas walkable, responding to the shifting body weight of an individual as they move. Works with all types of footwear, and the level of adhesiveness can be adjusted. Developed at the beginning of the 21st century by a carpet manufacturer, it has since been adopted for wider use, such as in spaceships and weightless areas of spaceports. Commonly called theater carpet due to it feeling somewhat similar to walking on a sticky movie theater floor. Yeah, I'm familiar with that. Adjustable glass. Glass that allows the level of transparency to be adjusted. The molecules of liquid crystals shift direction according to ambient temperature and electromagnetic field, causing changes in properties such as color and transparency. With adjustable glass, a thin layer of liquid crystals is placed between two sheets of glass, allowing the user to freely change the amount of light that enters the room. In addition to liquid crystals, God, I can't say that. Other substances such as oxidized tungsten are also used. Beretta 92F. The last handgun Beretta manufactured that uses gunpowder. A recoil gun, this is Jonathan Ingram's weapon of choice. He has modified his with a laser sight and uses special 10-round magazines with armor-piercing rounds. Bimodal system. A transportation system designed to alleviate the effects of traffic congestion by giving vehicles the ability to drive on railway lines. On Beyond Coast is intended for use by emergency vehicles such as police cars, ambulances, and fire engines. Charging station. A facility that provides electricity to automobiles. On Beyond Coast, any act that would pollute the air or disturb the sea lass, such as the burning of fossil fuels, is strictly prohibited. I'll go back to CLS again, because I know what it is now, I just can't explain it offhand. All vehicles use mainly clean electric power, therefore the colony contains charging stations in space in place of gas stations, with it taking about as much time to charge a vehicle as it does to fill one with gasoline. Furthermore, in order to prevent damage to the environment from heavy metals, all vehicle batteries are recovered and disposed of properly after use. Any act that would pollute the air or disturb the CLS is strictly prohibited. What CLS is this? Closed Ecological Life Support System. Independent biosphere. Unreliant on any outside assistance or intervention to sustain itself. Recycling energy and such. Alright. Is that what I read? No, I didn't read this one. I was reading charging station? Oh yeah. Clean energy requirement. The inhabitants of closed environments like Beyond Coast are required to use clean energy, such as electric power, instead of fossil fuels, which would pollute the CLS's air. Therefore, this prohibits the use of any fossil fuel internal combustion engines. Like cars and motorcycles that we know today. Eco-terrorists. Extremist individuals and groups in the environmental movement motivated by the pollution of outer space, most notably the accumulation of space debris since mankind first began exploring space. Past eco-terrorist atrocities include indiscriminately attacking beyonds visiting Earth, destroying space planes, destroying space colony facilities, and attacking ISPA members and buildings. Some of the larger organizations are the Repatriation Movement, and the group calling itself On the Earth. Eco-terrorists have become more active with the start of Beyond Coast's 30th Anniversary Festival, which, coincidentally, is going on right now. Yay! So we'll probably be fighting some of them. Foxhound, yeah, what's his name? I want to say Harry, it's not Harry. David? David was in this. Or Dave, rather. A high-tech special forces unit formed in the 1990s to respond to regional conflicts, local insurgencies, and terrorism. Foxhound differentiated itself from other special forces units with its application of one-man infiltration missions in situations of unconventional warfare. The unit's existence became known to the world as a result of the Galsberg Uprising of 1995 and the Zanzibar Land Disturbance of 1999. Its use of high-tech equipment in its infiltration missions had a significant influence on contemporary military strategy, resulting in other special forces units created in its image throughout the world. However, the unit was disbanded following its participation in the fall of Zanzibar Land, after it was revealed it had been genetically modifying its members. The birthplace of many a legendary soldier, Foxhound has since become popularly known as the Ninja Squad. Look at this. Featured in the MSX2 video games Metal Gear, 1987, and Metal Gear 2 Solid Snake, 1990. I love the references to the older games. Freaking awesome. Home support. Financial aid to protect Earth's environment, with the United Nations the principal contributor. Beyond Coast and other space colonies and bases are also asked to participate in this program. It is founded on the belief that the responsibility to protect Earth, or home, lies with all human beings, not just those currently living there. Linear elevator. An elevator that moves its cars by using a linear motor to raise and lower balance weights. Does not require a hoist mechanism or hydraulic device like previous elevators, reducing the amount of space required as well as offering lower energy consumption, faster movement, a more comfortable ride, and ultra-accurate stops between car and floor doors. Found in places such as the Tokugawa Building, which is right in front of us, which I guess we'll check that out. Linear Railway. Beyond Coast's magnetically levitated high-speed intelligent railway system, the colony's only mass transit system, also known as the Linear Rail, uses smart rail cars driven by linear motors capable of real-time status monitorings via a series of actuators as well as automatic navigation adjustment. Since the cars do not make contact with the tracks, they produce little noise or vibration, making it the ideal transportation system for a space colony. There are two types of railway lines on Beyond, the oval lines and the circle lines. The oval lines travel around each of the colony's three surface stripes, while the circle lines move between the three surface stripes. It has a top speed of 311 miles per hour. Sweet. Miranda warning, also known as Miranda rights, the legal rights that must be read to a suspect at the time of arrest. See, that hasn't changed. This rule has also been adopted on Beyond Coast. The wording of the warning, while differing by jurisdiction, typically is, you have the right to remain silent. Anything you say may be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to speak to an attorney and to have an attorney present during any questioning. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be provided to you if you so desire. Awesome. I like reading that. Negotiator. Someone who negotiates with kidnappers for the release of their hostages. Now this is what Jonathan did before he left to go back to Beyond. Some specialize in negotiating, but most negotiators also worked as private investigators. Although half of his work involves negotiating, Jonathan Ingram is a traditional private investigator as well. Negotiator privileges. A level of police authority, such as being able to enter houses related to investigations and possess firearms the general public is normally not permitted to own, afforded to negotiators in certain places of Earth. Parts of Earth, sorry. Police organizations on Earth where kidnappings are frequent eventually came to the conclusion that they were no longer equipped to deal with the kidnapping problem themselves. Negotiators are required to file annually with authorities regarding firearm possession, and they must also file a monthly report stating if and how they have used their privileges. However, many in the United States have questioned this practice, with the country having yet to pass the Kuntz gun control bill. Critics argue such allowances only add to the gun problem. Jonathan Ingram, who negotiates with kidnappers in his line of work, has negotiator privileges. Non-malt beer. A type of beer containing no malted barley. With the passage of the Liquor Tax Act of 2010 in the United States, the result of pressure from the neo-temperance movement, the tax for beer was divided into an alcohol tax and a malt tax. The increase in alcohol tax drove up the price of any beverage with 1% or higher alcohol content, with some even calling it effectively the return of prohibition. The simultaneous taxing of malted barley, a main ingredient of beer, meant that traditional beer was now too expensive for most drinkers. Non-malt beers avoid both of these taxes by limiting their alcohol content to 0.99% and by using cornstarch in place of malted barley. Wonder how that went over. Pharmaceutical sales representative. A pharmaceutical company employee whose job is to convince doctors and hospitals to deal in their company's products, often called sales reps for short. A sales rep's job description includes promoting their company and increasing sales, as well as explaining the effects of their company's products to those in the medical industry. Kenzo Hojo is a sales rep in addition to his other duties at Tokugawa Pharmaceuticals. Not only is he personally involved in the development of new drugs, but after a product is approved, he visits clinics and hospitals to promote it. So something about these new drugs, which aren't too new, they're already out on the market. Because he was the one who gave it to his wife, and then she gave it to Jonathan. Recoil gun. A gun that fires powder cartridges and utilizes a blowback, recoil, gas, or Gatling action. Once used extensively on Earth, they are now collectively known as recoil guns because when fired in zero gravity, the recoil launches the user backwards. This type of gun has fallen out of use as space expansion has progressed, as the recoil it produces cannot be suppressed in zero gravity. It is said that only collectors still purchase them. What about people who just don't go into space? Furthermore, as recoil guns leave a traceable rifling mark on the bullets they fire, whereas lift guns do not, they have become unpopular even among criminals. The production of powder cartridges used extensively with recoil guns has also fallen dramatically, and, like bent cigarettes, they are only available through special order. Jonathan Ingram's Beretta 92F is classified as a recoil gun. Tokugawa Group. A global Japanese conglomerate that can trace its origins to the 1950s when Zenzo Tokugawa formed Tokugawa Industries, a small local factory. It manufactured products such as lathe machine parts, but Zenzo's foresight ushered in significant growth and eventually turned Tokugawa Industries into Tokugawa Heavy Industries. The company went on to become a leading force in the Japanese shipbuilding and iron and steel industries. Tadashi Tokugawa took over the company in the 1980s, expanding it into semiconductors. Offshoot Tokugawa Electronics soon became the top electronics company in the world. In the 1990s, with its revolutionary biomaterials development and the business rockets and satellites it built with technology purchased from Russia, Tokugawa led the charge into outer space, setting the benchmark for commercial operations there. It also actively participated in the free flyer experiments from their inception, these experiments being the forerunner to the made-in-space industry, now the key to survival in space commerce. Tokugawa acquired a number of foreign companies at the start of the 21st century, transforming itself from a pseudo-zaibatsu into a global conglomerate. I don't know what a pseudo-zaibatsu is. Kind of a zaibatsu, which I don't know what that is. It went on to post its then biggest ever earnings with the third industrial revolution following the birth of the second space age. Joseph Sadayuki Tokugawa, the group's present head, resigned from BCP when Tadashi retired in 2020, becoming the new young leader of this empire. Taking advantage of his personal history as a Policenaut, he revamped the company's image and eliminated the so-called Japan bashing. Continue to page 2. Really? Page 2. Oh, look at that. Oh! I didn't know we could do that. Ha ha ha. That's pretty cool. That's the left and right directionals. Continue to page 2, alright. The group then expanded into markets that would become central to space development, such as satellites, rockets, spaceships, as well as the sensor and computer equipment these require. It also applied the high-tech architectural engineering experience it gained at places like Tokyo Waterfront and Zeofront? It's a little muddy there. I think it's Zeofront. To space base and space station construction, setting up the majority of space's infrastructure. These efforts had the added effect of lifting the construction industry out of depression and paving the way for fresh business models in space. Furthermore, Tokugawa established the first civilian base on the moon. Having devoted significant assets to space operations, Tokugawa proceeded into full-scale made-in-space development, manufacturing products in microgravity and extremely high vacuum environments, solidifying the conglomerate's dominance of outer space. Yeah, it doesn't dominate enough things, huh? It currently supports many areas of space development, not all of them for-profit enterprises. The Tokugawa Group today is divided into 138 companies. Heavy Industries remains its primary focus, with some of its larger operations being electronics, constructions, pharmaceuticals, foods, mining. The conglomerate's logo, the Mitsuba Aoi, if I'm saying that right, or three hollyhock leaves, is regarded throughout space as a symbol of absolute power. Tokugawa Hills, last one for this second-to-last entry, or category, rather. An exclusive residential district originally developed by a Japanese electronics firm shortly after Beyond Coast's completion. Tokugawa later bought the land from the electronics firm and is now home to its employees. Located in the middle of B sector at the far end of the colony, the area with the highest property values, it is situated on raised ground, positioning it slightly above surrounding areas and giving residents the best view of any ground area of the colony. In addition, this area is considered safer than others because it is located furthest from the colony's mirrors. Lots here are also allowed to make use of, to an extent, special layouts and modifications, even without the express permission of the Beyond Coast Architectural Committee, as well as have privately owned plants. Furthermore, select buildings are allowed to employ materials from Earth, such as real untreated lumber as well. Okay, last selection. Oh wow, we're gonna finish this episode, yay! Hydrogen engine. Unless these all have 4 pages each. An internal combustion engine that uses hydrogen for fuel. Hydrogen began gathering... I'm surprised there's not more in technology category. Hydrogen began gathering attention in the 20th century as a possible replacement for fossil fuels, with many even calling it a perfect energy source. The only byproduct of hydrogen combustion is water vapor. It produces neither carbon dioxide, a major contributor to global warming, nor any nitrogen oxide pollutants. The construction of Beyond Coast, which needs to maintain its sea last to survive, helped advance this technology considerably. It is also possible to store large amounts of hydrogen in transition metal hydrides, or compounds containing hydrogen in addition to a transition metal. These have reduced the amount of fuel storage space required compared to previous combustion engines. The hydrogen engine's high energy conversion rate has led to its use in the flight units of BCP's EMPS. There is also research being conducted to examine whether this type of engine can be used in motor vehicles on Beyond, which currently operate purely on electric and solar power. Linear skirt. A propulsion device attached to the underside of all police cars that allows their cars to drive on linear railway tracks. Part of a bimodal system, letting police officers use the tracks to bypass accidents or traffic jams in an emergency. However, this is only permitted in the event of an absolute emergency due to the wear this causes on the tracks. Other vehicles such as ambulances, fire engines, and linear railway maintenance cars are also equipped with a linear skirt. Police car. The patrol car BCP uses on Beyond Coast produces zero exhaust emissions in accordance with the colony's clean energy requirement. It is 6 parts electric, 4 parts solar powered, and is equipped with a linear skirt, which allows it to drive on linear railway tracks to bypass traffic accidents or congestion in an emergency. The license plates utilize a 3D data code system, the data of which can be read in real time. The car also has its own onboard AI, making it a smart car, but allows for manual operation as well, when pursuing a suspect, for instance. The body is constructed out of a full carbon fiber and aluminum honeycomb monocoque chassis. What about this? Is a clean energy requirement? Did we read this? Yes, I did read this. Two more. Ruthenium tetroxide fingerprinting. A fingerprint identification method employing ruthenium, a transition metal of the platinum group. Different from the ninhydrin method, which utilizes the ninhydrin reaction, naturally, the ruthenium tetroxide method can produce clean fingerprints from an area simply by exposing it to a reagent gas for 2 minutes. I knew that. Squid handcuffs. Abbreviation for superconducting quantum interference device handcuffs. A pair of handcuffs made of squid's inside superconducting metal rings. When activated, the rings are connected by a low-voltage electromagnetic arc. A handheld control device is used to adjust the intensity, shortening or lengthening the distance between the rings instantly. Squid handcuffs were developed in response to criticism from civil liberties organizations over how a suspect in a crime is to be restrained, as the individual has yet to be convicted of any wrongdoing. With squid handcuffs, law enforcement can deactivate the handcuffs at certain times and then reactivate them with the touch of a button as needed. This allows law enforcement to maintain control over the suspect while giving the suspect more freedom of movement than with previous types of handcuffs. These are the type of handcuffs BCP uses. Done! Recent. Okay, I read all this stuff. I thought reading the other articles would expose me to new things, new definitions, terms. That's it. Okay, cool. So I know this is a bit shorter episode, especially compared to the other episode from like 2 episodes ago, which was twice as long, but yeah, I did say it was going to be all glossary stuff, so I don't want anyone to miss anything when we go inside the Tokugawa Pharmaceutical Building. So that will definitely be next episode. We're all caught up with the glossary. I'm glad for that. And as I encounter new terms, which have the asterisk next to them, which I think is at least partly thanks to the translation team. Not sure if it's even present in the original game. New terms are asterisks, and I'll read them as we come to them. So, we'll move along that way. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode when we return to the game. Thanks for bearing with me, and I'll see you next episode. Always, seek adventure.